So there we have the lineup for the second semi-final heat. Bravo, Venezuela, Levine of Great Britain, Borle of Belgium, Pistorius of South Africa, Brown of the Bahamas, Kirani James of Grenada, Dildin of Russia, and McQuay of the United States, right on the outside. And really looking at this field, it's interesting that Blade Runner is in again, South African Oscar Pistorius, 145-44, but this man, one of the Borle twins, and here he has regained the Belgian record from his brother. But there's Bravo from Venezuela, 45-72, best at this season in his personal best in the qualification at 45-61, so it's already achieved, right on the inside. Well, this is Nigel Levine. He won the Oslo B race incidentally. His personal best from 45-78 to 45-11. He's third in the UK Championships, Nigel Levine. Good competitor though. And here is the Jonathan Borle. Fine family. Another brother and another sister along with the twins. But look at that. Qualified with 44-43. And that's the new national record. Pistorius, the double MQT, Blade Runner so called, but well received here. A man who has achieved so much. He runs the race so differently to the rest. Chris Brown of the Bahamas, Olympic semi-finalist in 2004, would have qualified for the final, but eased down. Remember the race, eased down and was passed. The world champion, Kirani James, he's only 19, he's the youngest ever world or Olympic champion at 400 metres. He's a big, solid citizen. 44-72 this year. That's Dildin, the Russian. And Dildin won the Russian title this year, his best of 45-01. It equates to his personal best this year, incidentally. And then Tony McQuay of the United States on the outside, who was second in his heat, 45-48. He was second in the US Olympic trials as well. So we're just the first two, plus the two fastest, to the final tomorrow. The second semi-final features a man who is the world champion against a pretender, really. Jonathan Borle is improving dramatically. And he has a very good lane in this second heat of the semi-final round. Pistorius will run this very steady over the first 200. He runs two even pace 200s. That's the nature of the blades he wears. Double amputee.
Set.
You'll see that Brown of the Bahamas will go off very quickly. Pistorius will come back in the second half of the race, that's for sure. Right on the outside, McQuay going very, very quickly indeed, followed by the Russian and James. The world champion inside him is Chris Brown, always going very quickly. Borle from the third lane in, that's lane four, there he is, the Belgian. Looking very, very strong indeed. And Brown in the light blue coming off the bend quite well here. Right on the outside then, McQuay has gone pretty well too. But here comes Kirani James, followed by Brown. It's the first two to go through by right. Borle's got a shift here, but he's going to go through as the fastest loser. James, Brown, and Borle, and 44-59. That wasn't the result that Borle wanted, and not the one I expected, quite frankly, but a good run by Chris Brown. And it's time 44-59, a season's best for the world champion, and a very good run by Chris Brown of the Bahamas. He absolutely flew around there, he did. And Jonathan Borle, we'll have to wait and see whether he's one of the two fastest losers. One more heat here. 44.99 for Borle. Half a second slower than he ran in the heat.
And not quite as quick as Pinder ran in the first race at 44.97. So although he's there at the moment, there's another race to go.
Yep.
So Kirani James here, the world champion from last year, striding along nicely here. Chris Brown, wonderful man at producing the goods when it really matters in a major championship. And he comes through in second place with Borle third, and an anxious wait to see whether he will get through. Suspect he might not, unless the next semi-final is a little slow. But he is in position at the moment, together with was it Solomon from Australia, who ran 44.97 in the previous race. Oscar Pistorius doing really well, of course, to make it through to an Olympic semi-final, but was tailed off in eighth place. So there's the results of the second semi-final. James 44.59, Brown 44.67, the two men who are sure to run in the final. Jonathan Borlée 44.99, we'll have that wait to see whether it's good enough. But a magnificent breakthrough here in the first of the semi-finals by Lalande Gordon. Smashed his personal best, what a time to do it, running 44.58, pinned to 44.94, and then Solomon, who's in position at the moment for a final place, at 44.97. Yusuf matching his personal best, 45.13. Well, we're so keenly anticipating this 100 metres. The semi-finals fully lived up to expectation. There are the great Jamaicans training together, great friends, with great rivals as well. Quite a contrast in heights, of course, the great Usain Bolt, he was 6'5", together with his friend, Johan Blake. And then, of course, we have the Americans, Justin Gatlin and Tyson Gay. What a race to savor. We've been looking forward to it for so long, and it really is building up to everything we might anticipate. As Stuart commented before, the men that ought to make the final have made the final. No real casualties in the semi-finals here. Justin Gatlin was magnificent in running 9.82. So what a race to savor is there. Just preparing, warming up there now, as we now come to semi-final number three of the men's 400 metres. Dane Hyatt of Jamaica, Lee Marvin Bonivaccia of Curaçao, who's got IOA, that's Independent Olympic Athlete, because Curaçao don't have an Olympic federation of their own. Kevin Borlée of Belgium, well, I wonder what he, if he knows his brother is on the brink, perhaps Kevin will knock him out. Luguelin Santos, then Bryson Nellum, Martin Rooney, Ramon Miller, and Yusuf Ahmed Mashrahi. That's the composition of the third and final semi-final of the men's 400 metres. The man, of course, who heads the world list this year, LaShawn Merritt, proved to be injured when it came to the first round, so he didn't manage to even complete his race then. So here are the runners then. Dane Hyatt, Jamaican, who at the age of 28 has made big improvement this year and is the Jamaican champion this season. One of the favourite Jamaicans, Jermaine Gonzalez, didn't progress beyond the heats. So a new man to look out for in the distinctive national colours. Dane Hyatt introduced to the Jamaican in the inside, lane two. Then the Curaçao man, 45.60. Kevin Borlée, who lost his Belgian record yesterday to his twin brother Jonathan. His best 44.56. Kevin has proven to be a fine championship competitor, European champion 2 years ago. Then the top junior, Luguelin Santos, Dominican Republic. Youngster, world junior champion, outstanding young talent, 18 years of age. Bryson Nellum from the USA came through to take third place in the US Championships. Former World Youth bronze medalist, then he got shot in a gang incident, but he's back in form. Now the crowd will appreciate the four times UK champion, Martin Rooney. He was a finalist in Beijing 2008, and quite recaptured the top form so far this year. Ramon Miller took the bronze medal in the Commonwealth Games and was a Pan American bronze medalist also last year. Thanks for the Bahamas. Finally, we have last year's Asian champion, Yusuf Ahmed Mashrahi. So in this lineup, all but Bonavaccia and Mashrahi have broken 45 seconds. So nice evening here in London, but it's getting a bit chillier than sprinters would prefer for fast times. We have had to do useful runs, 44.58 and 44.59 winning times in the two previous semi-finals. Martin Rooney of Great Britain settles into his blocks in lane 7 of the third semi-final, the 400 metres. Well, Kevin Borley in the red of Belgium is off fast, and outside him you've got the youngsters, Luguelin Santos, but right out there, Ramon Miller of Bahamas already has gone past Mesrahi. Rooney running pretty well. There's not much to choose between the athletes apart from Mesrahi being a little bit down. Certainly Miller of Bahamas has gone out very well too. The crowd are giving support for Rooney. The two lanes inside him, the youngster Santos also running very well indeed. Kevin Borley still well in contention as they swing into the home straight now. It's Santos, the youngster, being trapped by Kevin Borley. The race is on behind them, with Miller maintaining his form, but now being challenged by Miller of America. But up front, it's the youngster Santos who chases across the line. Kevin Borley is in second place. In third place is Bryson Miller. Not sure he's done quite enough though. The time, we'll see. It's going to be close, very close. 44.78, the winning time confirmed for Luguelin Santos of the Dominican Republic. Kevin Borley, make sure that we've got at least one Borley in the final that we're going to look at with interest to see. Borley's time is 44.84. What was the time of the third man, Nellum? 45.02, he's not made it. So that means that Solomon and Jonathan Borley will go through to the final.
Well, this is quite a positive run, wasn't it, by the youngster, by the 18-year-old, a maturity beyond those years, and he holds his form very, very well indeed. A little look right and then a little look left, and really coming off the World Junior Championships and performing incredibly well at 44.78, and he's easing down at the end, isn't he? Right that Bryson Nellum of the United States came in third place, and he got a time of, what, 45.02. So 44.78, 44.84, they're the two qualifiers by right. Martin Rooney run out of it again.
Yeah, Fred, he's just not in top form this year. He started promisingly, but a time of 45.31, which I think would be deeply disappointing for him.